वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द अनदर टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो इन दिस चैप्टर द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस और फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो और डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो फ्रॉम द जाइगोट. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट रिवाइज आवर प्रीवियस क्लास कंटेंट. दैट इज इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी वॉज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन और एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन द रिप्रोडक्शन टॉपिक. सो इन द रिप्रोडक्शन देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑफस्प्रिंग बाय द यंग एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म गिव्स राइज टू देयर यंग वंस बाय डिफरेंट मोड और डिफरेंट मेथड दैट इज एसेक्सुअल और सेक्सुअल मोड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. इन द एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन विदाउट एनी इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ सेकेंड पार्टनर और सेकेंड पेरेंट सिंगल ऑर्गेनिज्म कैन रिप्रोड्यूस इट सेल्फ टू अ न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म. बट द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच इज फॉर्म बाय अ सिंगल पेरेंट इज एक्चुअली टोटली आइडेंटिकल टू देयर पेरेंट्स विद देयर पेरेंट्स बिकॉज देर इज नो क्रॉसिंग ओवर एंड देर इज ऑल्सो ड्यू टू द एब्सेंस ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेशन द ऑफस्प्रिंग हैव द सेम जेनेटिक कैरेक्टर विद देयर ऑफ देयर पेरेंट्स. So these are the some important characteristics of asexual reproduction. Now come to the sexual reproduction. In the sexual reproduction, there is involvement of two parents. The gamete formation takes place in a single organism or as well as in two organism. But मतलब दोनों organism में भी हो सकते हैं gamete का formation. But in the sexual reproduction. But in the sexual reproduction, due to the involvement of two gametes of fusion of two gametes, there is crossing over or during the gamete formation or recombination of two genetic content of different organism to different parents. So that indicates the actually variation in the formation of offspring or variation in the genetic character. Let us move about the what is syngamy. Syngamy takes place in the organism that is fusion of two gametes is known as syngamy. Then when the fusion of two gametes takes place, this is also known as the fertilization. The fertilization in which there is the process by which the male gamete can transfer their nucleus into the egg cell. So because both the gamete those are formed either side of the organism or parents, they may be identical, may not be identical, that is may be differ from that one is motile, second one is non motile. Generally female gametes are stationary or non motile, but the male gamete are motile. But in few cases the male gametes are also non-motile, as in case of seeded plants or angiosperm. In seeded plant, the male gamete is formed inside the pollen grain or angiosperm. They are also non-motile. Due to the non-motile, the plant have the ability. That they transfer their gametes inside the egg by the different method, that is pollination, where the transfer of pollen grain on the stigma are carried out by the different factors, abiotic and biotic factors, and after the transfer the pollen tube formation occur, and the pollen tube are actually able to transfer the sperm into the embryo sac. Due to the non-motile, but in some cases the male and female both gametes are motile, as in case of cladophora, both the male and female gametes have the flagella, two flagella, and zoospores actually are asexual bodies which also have the flagella. In some of the plants, actually they form the similar structure to the asexual spores and is as in cladophora. Now let's move द टूडेज टॉपिक दैट इज जायगोट तक हमने डिस्कस कर लिया था इन प्रीवियस क्लास में, इन विच द फर्टिलाइजेशन कैरिड आउट आइदर एक्सटर्नल और इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन आर कैरिड आउट इन डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट इज फ्यूजन ऑफ टू मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड द फीमेल बॉडी और आउटसाइड द फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड फ्रॉम द फीमेल बॉडी दैट इज इन द एनवायरमेंट जनरली इन द वॉटर एज इन केस ऑफ एम्फीबियंस. After the fusion, the embryogenesis takes place. That is, after the fusion, when the syngamy occurs, the two gametes fuses with each other and form the zygote. That may be that the zygote is universally diploid in condition because two nuclei fuses and form the zygote. That is two and in condition after the zygote undergoes in mitosis division or differentiation. And form the embryo. So here is the embryo. Embryogenesis, that is development of embryo. Development of embryo. Embryo development takes place. Inside the or outside the organism. So this process development of embryo is done when the zygote undergoes in mitosis division. Here the zygote undergoes in mitosis division. After the mitosis division, the formation of the embryo, that is development of embryo. Now mitosis division in some of the organism, generally the mitosis division takes place after the formation of zygote, that is in the development of embryo, and after mitosis there will be another type of differentiation takes place by the differentiation which actually able for differentiate or for the formation of different type of cells in the embryo. Now when the egg fertilize, after the fertilization the egg because in the higher plants the egg formation occur inside the embryo sac, or in after the when the egg fertilize the egg is converted into zygote or zygote is converted into the embryo. Now the embryo sac or ovule, inside the ovule converted into seed and the ovary converted into the fruit. So this conversion is also takes place inside the angiospermic plants. But in case of what about the lower plants, that is bryophytes, algae, these are also because as we already know the body of the bryophytes are haplontic type, but the angiosperm, the body of the angiospermic are the diplontic type, that is sporophytic body of the angiosperm, whereas the bryophytes, the main plant body is actually gametophyte. So as we already know the in the sporophyte the ploidy of the sporophyte will always be 2n, that is diploid, but in case of gametophyte the ploidy of gametophyte always be haploid. So when the haploid plant undergoes in the gamete formation, they always follow the mitosis division. In the that means undergoes in the mitosis division. After the mitosis division, in the lower plants there will be formation of the gametes. And meiosis division kab hoga? Because the this process takes place in angiosperm. Angiosperm mein ye process hota hai. Rest of the other organism, lower organism, as in case of bryophytes and or algae, because the main plant body actually main plant is gametophyte. Main plant is gametophyte and the ploidy of gamete, these gametophyte is M, that is haploid. Haploid. Haploid hai. So then when the this plant undergoes in meiosis, undergoes in the formation of gamete, so because ab yahan pe haploid condition hai, so there is no such condition in which the gamete have the ploidy of N by 2. Because after the meiosis, when the cells of this gametophyte undergoes in the gamete formation, they, if they follows the follows the meiosis division, so because we know the in the meiosis division, that meiosis division is actually a reduction division. In the reduction division, there will be the chromosome actually half of their parents, plant body or other other cells of the that gametophyte. So there is no such condition in which the n by 2 number of chromosome present inside the gamete. So gamete will be always haploid. So that plant undergoes in the mitosis division. After the mitosis division, they form the sperm or ovum. Sperm and ovum or egg formation occur on the gametophyte. And after the fusion, because as we know, the sperm here is also haploid, because undergoes in mitosis division, there is no such condition or ki jahan pe the gamete form have the n by 2 number of chromosome. N by 2, that means ki 1/4 of the actual chromosome or diploid condition. So aise koi bhi condition nahi hogi for that. For the gamete formation, the gametophyte undergoes in the mitosis division. Now, next is because in the fertilization there is fusion of in the sexual reproduction, because algae and fungi, algae and bryophytes also reproduce by asexual or as well as the sexual reproduction. So when they undergoes in the sexual reproduction, the fusion of gametes, these gametes carried out by the organism, and after the fusion of sperm and ovum, that is fertilization of same gamete, the zygote formation occur. That is zygote always, here is N and ovum is N, always N. So after the fusion, the again diploid condition. Whenever the zygote undergoes in the formation of development, and when the seed, or because they are non-seeded plants, lekin agar isi se direct agar sperm zygote se agar plant, whole plant ka development hoga, to because the zygote is actually diploid in condition, so the plant developed from the zygote, the ploidy of that plant will also become the diploid condition, that is sporophytic. The plant shows the sporophytic. So for the maintenance of the ploidy, the zygote then undergoes in meiosis division. Zygote undergoes in meiosis division. After the meiosis division, there is formation of the 4 haploid spores. Spores ka formation hoga, that spores is haploid. 4 haploid spores. Spores ka formation hoga. Ye spores kaise honge? Haploid in condition. Then spores undergoes in germination, and after the germination process, the spores is converted into the adult. Into the adult plant, that is gametophyte actually. So they shows the alternation of generation. Now these are the exception, because we discussing about the reproduction in organisms, so we must I must have include that the if there is difference in between the bryophytes and algae, so ye difference hota hai in respect to the reproduction or formation of the spores or meiosis or mitosis division. Now come to the embryogenesis process. Now, because as we know, in the seeded plants, in the seeded plant, the sperms are non-motile. The transfer of these sperm with the help of pollen grain pollination, or also with the help of pollen tube. So pollen tube transfer the sperm inside the pistil. Pistil, that is ovary or gynoecium. Inside the gynoecium, there is ovule present. Now inside the ovule, or there is presence of the different type of cells. That is synergids and antipodal cells, or then egg cells inside the embryo cell. So here is embryo sac. The whole structure is known as ovule. Inside the embryo cell, there is egg which converted into the zygote. Or outside the ovule is protected into the ovary. Ovary is covered by the gynoecium. Here is gynoecium. Now this structure actually represented by the angiospermic gynoecium. So after the fertilization, because the one sperm fuses with the, there is the actually two type of fertilization we discuss in the next chapter. We will discuss in the next chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. We will discuss how the fertilization, what is double fertilization, what is syngamy, triple fusion, and how the formation of embryo takes place inside the seed. Or ये सभी जो main topic है, we will discuss in the next chapter. Now in this chapter एक overall view देख लेते हैं. So after fertilization, the sperm fuses with the egg, because here is egg, and the egg converted into the zygote. And after the zygote undergoes in mitosis division. After the mitosis division, there's formation of the embryo. Now next, the egg is present inside the ovule. That is, inside the ovule, egg ke siva, other cells are also present inside the ovule, that is synergid cells and antipodal cells. The antipodal cells and synergid cells degenerated after the fertilization process, after the syngamy. So inside the ovule, there is only egg which is converted into zygote, and after the zygote there will be the formation of the embryo. Now so the ovule is converted into the, which actually covers the egg. The egg, because converted into the embryo, or an ovule converted after the fertilization converted into seed. And the ovary, which actually, here is ovary, ovary converted into the fruit. Ovary converted into the fruit. So this condition, all these conversion takes place after the fertilization or after the syngamy. Now another cell inside the ovule or embryo sac, here is embryo sac. Inside the embryo, because zygote is present, zygote is converted into the embryo. Now here is another cell, that is polar nuclei, is converted into the endosperm. Now polar nuclei converted into the endosperm. So all this conversion takes place after the fertilization. Now, so the development of embryo may or may not be carried out in the female body. So if the fertilization or takes place outside the body or outside the body, as well as the formation of embryo also takes place outside the body or in the environment, that kind of organism is known as oviparous, because they lays egg or their egg develop in the environment or outside the body. So that kind of animal is known as, so that kind of fertilization is known as actually the oviparous organism, because they lay their egg in the atmosphere or in the environment, or the development of organism or offspring takes place inside the environment. So this process is takes place. So this process is takes place in different organism. For example, the birds are oviparous organism because they lay their egg in the environment, and they gives rise to young ones or offspring develop actually in the environment or inside the egg, which actually lays in the environment. So that's why they are known as the oviparous organism. So लेकिन हम अगर different organism, even human and other mammals की बात करें तो they does not lay egg or do not lay egg in the environment, or the fertilization takes place inside the body of the female, and development of embryo or the fetus offspring takes place inside the organism. So that type of organism is known as, the whole development takes place inside the organism. That's why that type of organism is known as viviparous organism. So on the basis of the formation of embryo inside or outside the environment, the organism is included into two different types or two different ways, that is oviparous or viviparous, because organism develop their offspring in inside the female body or outside the female body. If the development of offspring takes place inside outside the female body, outside the female body, outside the female body. So this type of fertilization is development is known as the oviparous organism. Oviparous organism. Now next is the viviparous organism. The oviparous also indicated by the with the female, or because the female lay egg. If the organism lays, or next example is, or the definition is, if the female or organism female lay egg, so that kind of organism or organism are also known as the oviparous organism. If female birth the offspring, so this type of organism is known as the viviparous organism. विविपेरस ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो विविपेरस ऑर्गेनिज्म कौन से होंगे? दोस गिव राइज टू देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग, बर्थ टू देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग, एंड दोस अनेबल टू गिव राइज टू देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग अनेबल, बट दे लेज एग, फर्टिलाइज और अनफर्टिलाइज एग. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म आर नोन एज ओविपेरस ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो नाउ यहाँ पे ये चैप्टर एंड होता है यहाँ पे, लेकिन यहाँ पे कुछ इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रह गए हैं. दैट आर द आफ्टर, ये तो ऑर्गेनिज्म के रिस्पेक्ट में थे, बट इन द केस ऑफ प्लांट द प्लांट्स आर ऑल्सो विविपेरस और ओविपेरस ऑर्गेनिज्म. Because in the viviparous type of organism, when the seed germinate on the plant, that type of plant is known as viviparous organism. Or if the seed germinate in the soil, that type of plant is known as oviparous organism. तो प्लांट्स के रिस्पेक्ट में भी ये टर्म्स यूज किए जाते हैं. इफ द सीड जर्मिनेट ऑन द प्लांट, दैट टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म इज नोन एज विविपेरस, एंड इफ द सीड जर्मिनेट इन द सॉइल और आउट ऑफ द प्लांट बॉडी, सो दैट टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म और प्लांट्स आर नोन एज ओविपेरस ऑर्गेनिज्म. नेक्स्ट इज व्हेन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो टेक्स प्लेस आउट द embryo takes place from the zygote, there is formation of the apicarp structure, that is seed and pericarp that protect the seed and fruit. Actually, fruit, the covering of the ovary. ओवरी की कवरिंग को हम पेरिकार्प बोलते हैं, एंड इन साइड द पेरिकार्प द सीड इज प्रोटेक्टेड इन साइड द ovary, so that's why the ovary is covered by the tough or resistant pericarp. Now यहाँ पे chapter ये end होता है. हम next class में next chapter discuss करेंगे, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. इससे पहले हम ये revise कर लेते हैं कि क्या क्या हमने इस chapter में discuss किया, that is reproduction, type of reproduction, asexual or sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, there are different way to different method actually utilized by the organism, that is budding, by budding method, by multiplication division, by binary fission. They undergoes in asexual reproduction. In case of plants, they undergoes in the asexual reproduction is actually termed as vegetative reproduction. In the plants, vegetative reproduction is done by the bulb formation of bulbils, by the formation of runners, by the formation of offsets, and leaf margin of some plants, bryophyllum, also undergoes in the for development of new offspring. Now the potato eyes undergoes or tubers are undergoes in the asexual reproduction and vegetative reproduction, and rhizomes formed by the ginger and banana also reproduce the new organism, have ability to reproduce the new organism. Now sexual reproduction, there is formation of gametes, two type of gametes, and fusion of these two type of gametes. The formation of gametes either takes place on same plant or maybe on different plant. If the same plant they form these male or female reproductive part or gametes, that type of plant is known as monoecious. Is if they form on different organism, two different organism, that type of plant or animal is known as the unisexual organism or dioecious organism. Or homothallic or heterothallic terms are also used for that type of organism. Homothallic are same as unisexual or hermaphrodite organism, or heterothallic are dioecious organism. So in the asexual reproduction, there is formation of two gametes, and fusion of these two gametes takes place in the organism or out the organism. That type of fusion is known as external fertilization or internal fertilization. सो एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन दैट इज आउटसाइड द फर्टिलाइजेशन हो रहा है फीमेल बॉडी के एंड इनसाइड इफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड द बॉडी दैट टाइप ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन इज नोन एज इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन इफ द डेवलपमेंट आर ऑल्सो टेक्स प्लेस इन द ऑर्गेनिज्म इनसाइड द ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म इज नोन एज विविपैरस इफ द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो टेक्स प्लेस आउटसाइड द ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म इज नोन एज ओविपैरस सो दीज आर नाउ After the fertilization, the zygote is converted into the embryo, the ovule is converted into seed and ovary is converted into the fruit. These modification takes place after the fertilization and they are also included into the post-fertilization events. Now, here is the topic, here is the chapter. Now, next class mein, now hum next topic or chapter discuss karenge, tab tak ke liye. Thank you, students.